welcome everybody to Wednesday Night Yin, whether you're here in the studio, or you're back at home, right? We're going to start tonight, we're starting on the back. What happened here in the studio? Bring the blanket into a little Tootsie Roll, so you've got the blanket, and then you just roll it up so it's like one long little line, and then put it underneath your knees as you lie back. It's the pressure off your low back starts to open up your legs, like I was saying to them. Lots of work tonight in the legs, so that's why I had it there. Jeez, I don't know what I did with this camera angle. I'm gonna have to move further back. But that's where I want you to be right now. You guys all go there. Take your first few moments. Just start to let yourself arrive on the mat. It's not vinyasa, so you don't have to control your breath so much. Just let yourself become aware of your breath. So you can breathe. Noticing your breath, you're observing your breath, you're letting it push out all those other distractions. Become fully focused on your mat, your practice, fully present to your mat, your practice. When you go down, Sarah, get another moment or two to arrive. We're still getting all settled here in the studio. It's all good.
All right, yoga music by Spa Music, playing on Spotify.
Feel heavy here, wherever you are, wherever you found yourself. Whatever parts of you touch the mat, sink into the mat. Whatever parts of you touch the blanket, then sink into the blanket. Thank you. right here. Now, you're going to take your knees and hug them in to your chest. Take that blanket. Just going to move it off to the side. So we're here on our back with the knees and the chest. We're going to do some lumbar circles right here before we come up. So you're going to let your knees go over to the right side of your body. Then push them away from your body. Bring them to the left and then pull them all the way back in. It's like you're circling around your sacrum, the low part of your back. Just do that 3 or 4 times. One complete breath for each circle that you make. And from there, when you've got your knees hugged all the way in again, right, just switch directions. You can bounce to the left, push them away, bring them to the right, back in. Circle around here. Just 3 or 4 times. You to come around to tabletop. Here you can use the blanket if you want to. You can put it under your knees to give yourself a little bit of padding. Right? If you don't need the blanket under your knees, if that doesn't bother you, then you don't need to take it here. Right? I'm going to come right here now and see if you can see everything I'm doing from here. So we're here in this tabletop. Now, what I want you to do is take your right foot and step it out to the right. Just like this, right? And then you're going to bring your hips back over your heels. Keep your hands where they are. Maybe they have to pull a little bit back toward you. So you look like this, right? And see, as I came back, see my right toes have come up. Now what I'm going to do here is try to push them back to the mat. Now if you can't get your hips all the way, your left hip all the way to your left heel, it's okay, right? You might look like this, and that's okay. Just push your hips back as far as you can. Maybe you can walk your hands out a little further so you're really feeling it. Right? You can come all the way down, come all the way down. Now like that half child's pose. You should feel it through the inner thigh. We're going to take 4 more breaths here. When you're ready, bring your hands back by your right knee. Right? So support by your right knee as you push yourself up. Better. Come back into your tabletop. Bring that right knee in. Now let's try that going the other way. So you're in tabletop. Just take your left foot, step it out to the left. Move this blanket out of the way so you guys can see what's going on with my left foot. So I'm here. Now see how my toes are pointed forward? I'm going to try to keep them pointed forward. As I come back, maybe my toes are going to come up and that's okay, right? So I'm going to go back as far as I can here, which is not as far from me on this side as on the other side. But once I get down as far as I can go, I'm going to try to take those left toes, put them back on the floor towards the front of the room. And again, if you didn't get your hip all the way to your heel, maybe you're halfway. You're right here. That's all right. Walk your hands a little more forward, maybe. Maybe you can get all the way down so you really start to feel that stretch wherever you are. Take 4 more breaths. Take your right hand, drop it to your right side. Just reach those left fingertips Right over your head, right? Left bicep by the left ear. And then bring both hips back up to the side. Now just bring yourself back into tabletop. As you go to tabletop, now you can untuck the toes. Oh, just feel good. And a little patty cushion on the mat. Next, we're slowly getting our lower body away here. What I want you to do here, drop your hips to one side or the other. Swing your legs around in front of you. Alright? So we're just sitting up tall here. Now we're going to do a series of forward folds here. We're going to start, we're going to do all three on the right side, and then we're going to do all three on the left side. Right? Have all your props handy. Sometimes you need them in these, sometimes not. Right? We're going to start with the easiest one. If the next one is too much stretch for you, we'll go back to the easier one. Alright? And I'll give you all the options. But right now, keep your right foot extended all the way forward. Keep your right heel down on the mat. Bend into your left knee. Bring the sole of your left foot against your right inner thigh. Right now, angle yourself towards your right leg. All we're going to do here, you're going to walk yourself over that right leg. Right, then you can grab onto your right foot. Keep your hands just on the mat on either side. Right. If your left knee's way up in the air and it's not comfortable to you, this is where your props fit. Maybe you take a block, put it underneath your left knee to support it. We're here for a little longer than we usually are, right? You do the same thing with a blanket. If your blanket comes under your knee. You want to bring your chest right over your right thigh, bring your nose towards your right knee. You start to feel that lengthening through your right hamstring. You guys stay here. Stay here for a minute or two. I'm going to come up. The music's really loud now. I'm going to see if I can make the volume go down and feel maybe I'm talking to this thing around where I'm lost to work it. Hey Google, set volume level 4. So we're going to try to do each of these stretches for 2 minutes, right? So you've been here for about a minute. Let me hang out here for another minute. You put a little bend in your right knee, it's okay, right? You have to lock out that knee, but you don't want to bend it a whole lot. If you have to be here, that's okay. All you're doing is grabbing onto your knee. That's fine. That's where your body went. You should feel a slight pull in your low back as you twist your upper body towards your right leg. Ready, slowly start to come back up. Alright, now here we're going to go into this half hero. It's just the forward fold, right? It's on the back end. So a lot of you are going to be scared of this. You're like, no, I can't do this. It's much different when we're folding forward than if we're trying to lean all the way back, right? So here's what I want you to do. Put your left foot flat on the ground, right? Now lean to the right. Let yourself come down all the way to your right fore. Then you can take that left foot and just peel the left foot back behind you. Then push yourself up and see how that feels, right? You want to be in a place where you've got your knees next to each other and your right heel is outside the right hip. So you're not pulling that leg under you, right? You're not sitting on your hip. It's going to make you feel like you're listing a little bit to the right for a lot of people, I should say. It doesn't feel like that for everybody. Some of us does, right? So we're going to walk ourselves out. What I usually do here, my torso is still coming right along my right leg. But I kind of brace myself with my right arm. Now you can use your block, right? You can use your palm. Push your hip square and just reach towards your right foot with your left hand. Now, if this is absolutely too much for your right knee, and you feel like you can't stay here for the 2 minutes because you're feeling it in your left, I shouldn't say right knee, in your left knee, then you're gonna come around and you're just gonna come right back into that butterfly again. It's okay with your knee, right? You don't have to go very far. Again, you're pushing yourself up with your right hand so that you're not here, right? It's not like this. Falling over to the right. I'm up and I'm straight. I like to take my block, really put it by my right hip and rest my right elbow on it. That way I feel like I can put just enough pressure in that right up, right arm to get myself square. Once you're all the way up, then let yourself lean all the way over to the right so you can easily kick that left foot back in front of you. All right, so now we're going to go to our last forward fold version on the right side. Now you're going to bend into your left knee here, and what you're going to do, right, it's not like a butterfly. I want you to pick your left foot up and put it, ideally you've got that left heel all the way to the crease of your hip, and you're letting that right knee fall open, or left knee fall open, and my left knee would come down to the ground, which doesn't happen, right? But I can get my heel to where it needs to be. I can always use a block, and I can be like this, and then you're going to fold over, you're not going to go as deep, right? Now, you can slide that foot down a little bit further, right? It might be like this, it might be down. As long as it's above your knee, it's okay, right? See if you can get it up there, so, right? And you're going to come forward. Now, it's okay here. You're not going to come as far forward as you did when you were in that full butterfly, right? So that's, feel like, oh, I'm not getting down as far. No, you're still okay, right? Take the stretch right there. If it's absolutely killing your left knee or it feels awkward to you, and you feel like you can't do this, then again, you're just going to come back to that regular half butterfly here, right? But if you can, bring that foot up. Let that knee come open. Right? My knee can survive. If it's got some support, it makes it a lot easier on your left knee. Are you on your left side the whole time? Mm-hmm. Oh, okay, let me do this the next time. Or so here. Three more breaths. And then slowly let yourself come all the way up here and gently slide that left foot down. Now we're going to take your left leg all the way long here. And then once we get our left leg all the way long, we're going to do those same stretches I showed in the block over here, right? We're going to do the same stretches on the other side. So this time, first you just bend into your right knee. Right, and let that sole of the right foot come against your left hand thigh. Let your right knee fall open. Now if you need to here, you can always take a block or the blanket, prop your right knee up, give it a little bit of support. It comes down to the mat. If it's not bothering you, you don't have to worry about it. But here we're turning our torso towards our left leg, and then you're going to walk yourself forward. Again, maybe here you can grab on to your left foot. Maybe you're just at your ankle or your shin or your knee. Hands can be on your leg, it can be on either side of your leg. But make sure that torso stays angled towards the left leg, nose and towards the left knee. Okay? That's what we should look like in all three of these poses that we're going to do. It's just the easiest to do in this one, right? Here and slowly bring yourself all the way up. Right, so now we're going to go to that half hero version of the pose. So you're going to lean yourself. Well, first, take your right leg straight, right? She's that first. Bend to your right knee, just plant that right foot on the ground. Lean to the left, you can come all the way down to your forearm, right? So that you can take a hold of the outside of your right ankle or right leg, and then pull that foot back behind you. You want your right knee to drop as close to your left knee as you can get it. Right, then push yourself back up, square your hips towards the front of the room. And then you're gonna walk in here over that left leg. So you can brace yourself with your left hand, right? You don't wanna be here where you're listing way over. You wanna get it so that your hips are square, right? So I'm using my hand or my elbow, right, to push myself up to square my hips. That's the whole goal here. Reach with your right hand. Towards your left foot. Maybe you grab it. You're just getting close. It's all good. And if this absolutely is not going to happen on your right knee, then you're going to turn around and make it that butterfly again. thing we're going to do here. I'm excited to do that. Draw a new forward fold. That's where we bend in to the right knee. Now you're going to pick up your right foot. You're trying to get that right heel into the crease of your left hip. It doesn't work as well for me on this side, really. Look how much higher my right knee is. It's just how my body is, right? The other side's a lot looser, this side's tighter. So maybe I slide my ankle down a little bit further, right? Maybe I'll let that knee come up higher. I'm going to prop underneath it with the block, give it a little bit of support. Angle yourself still over that left leg and lean forward. And again, you're not going to come as far forward here as you did when you were doing half butterfly, no matter how flexible you are. There's meant to be a little more restriction in this pose. Take your last 2 minutes here. More breaths here. Slowly slide that right leg off your left. Take that right leg straight in front of you. Right? Now, just for a couple breaths, right? Your legs are extended long in front of you. You're going to really flex your feet so your toes are coming back towards your face, but keep your heels on the ground. Take your hands, bring your hands right next to your hips. Your same hand is by your same hip. Push your palms into the ground, so lengthen out your spine. Right? Like there's a string on top of your head. You're being pulled up towards the ceiling. You're going to stay on the ground, but you really should feel some weight in those palms, you're pushing yourself up. We call this staff pose. Right, it's work right here. We're not staying here for 2 minutes, but we're gonna stay for 4 more breaths. Really think about your thigh bones pushing down into the mat as you push your palms into the mat. One more breath. And then let yourself relax down. Take those hands away. Now, what we want to do next, right? We're going to come into a seated forward fold, just a basic one. But I want you to prop underneath your knees, right? So you put a little bend in your knees. You could use your block, right? It slides underneath your knees, and it could be right here. You can come back, make that Tootsie Roll again with your blanket, right? Remember, it goes into quarters, and then you roll it up towards the fringe. Make that Tootsie Roll. Let it go right under your knees if that feels good, right? If you're at home, and you don't have either of those things, you can grab a throw pillow from your couch, you can grab a pillow from your bed, or any blanket you have, right? Just get your knees a little bit elevated. I'm going to use my block. I like to use the block because it's nice and firm, and I feel like I'm actually getting that elevation, right? But then you've got to keep your legs close enough together because the block's not as long, right? Now, what I want you to do here, once you've got whatever you're going to put there in place, right, you're going to take your hands up to the sky, lengthen out, turn your palms toward your toes, and then just put your belly on your thighs. Let your hands land wherever they are going to land. Okay? This is our yin pose. So we don't want to yang actions. There's no necessity to grab the feet. Right? If your hands actually reach your feet, then let them go there. Right? You don't have to take that extra to reach. Right? Just let yourself float into the pose and stay right there. I'm looking up so I can talk to you, right? But what you should do is have the crown of your head pointed straight towards the front of the room, your nose pointed right in between your knees. So you're not here looking up, you're not here tucking your chin, driving your head down. Right? to feel your sit bones on the floor. You want your toes to go up towards the ceiling. You want your knees to go up to the ceiling. You don't want to let your legs fall out, right? Because that's going to take the stretch you're trying to get here out of it. Now your hands are going to come right in the center. And you're just going to walk yourself forward. Now you can use your block here. Sometimes I do, right? It keeps a connection between your hands and the earth and lets you move a little bit further forward. You don't have to use the block. You can just have your hands flat on the mat. If you can get pretty low, on a good day I can do this, right? With the block at its highest level, you can use it as a landing place for your head. Since my forehead comes to the block, the crown of my head is still pointed straight ahead. And I can rest my head there on the block. Right, because again, just like in that last fold we did, you want to keep your back nice and flat. You're not trying to get your head to the ground by tucking your chin to your chest and driving your forehead towards the ground. Keeping your back perfectly flat. So even if I use the block under my forehead, my back is still flat, the crown of my head is still forward. I'm gonna stay here for 2 minutes, wherever you are. Again, think about your legs. Want those toes to stay pointed towards the ceiling. Keep those knees pointed towards the ceiling. It's a stretch for the inner thighs. That's where you feel it, right along your inner thighs. If you're not feeling anything, maybe you need to take your legs a little wider. Maybe take a breath, see if you can walk your hands a little further out. I promise eventually you'll start to feel it. You want to get to that edge. So there's a little bit of sensation, a little bit of discomfort, but not so much of either that you can't stay here for the full 2 minutes. Press here. Top of your left knee and let that right knee fall out to the side. Right, so it's kind of like that drosna we did before, but now we're on our back. Right? We're going to open up the right hip here. So what you're going to do here, you're going to pick up your left foot. Start to draw that left thigh in towards your body. That's going to make you start to feel that stretch in your right hip. Now your right hand is going to come to the inside of your left thigh. Your left hand is going to come to the outside of your left thigh. So hopefully you can interlace your hands behind your left thigh here. And then the closer you pull that left leg to your body, the more you're going to feel the stretch in your right hip. You're going to kick your left leg up to the sky if that feels good. You're going to drop that left heel all the way to your glute and around your hands, around your left shin. Right? You can stay with your knee just slightly bent. It's all good. And you take your right elbow and use it to push that right knee open a little bit more. That changes the stretch slightly. You want to, again, be in that place where you're feeling sensation in the right hip. A lot of sensation, a little discomfort, but not so much that you can't hang out. Back it off by letting that left leg come further away from your body. You intensify it by pulling that left leg closer in to your body. torso over to the edge of your mat. Just let that left foot come to the edge of the mat. You're going to take your arms into cactus arms, right? That means my elbows are even with my shoulders, and then my fingertips are reaching towards the back of the room. That little goalpost position with my arms. Now from here, you're going to use your right foot. You're going to draw that left knee over, and both knees are going to fall over to the right. And then you're going to take your chin to gaze over your left shoulder. Now, probably your right knee is not coming to the ground, right? So again, you can use your block here, right? And let the block support the right knee so that wherever it lands on top of that block, right? Or if it feels okay hanging out in space, it can hang out in space. We're trying to open up the legs, so we want that sensation. But I want you to be able to hang out here for a few breaths. So if you need that block to get that stability, then use it. Put it straight under your knee, around your right thigh, and then how low the legs go. Right? It's not about your knees have to come to the ground, it's about you want to feel that stretch on the outside of your right hip, right leg. We were talking a little bit last week about the chakras, and all the ones we did last week were all heart openers, right? Opening up the heart chakra. Everything we do tonight, everything we have done and will do, it's really about opening up that root chakra. The root chakra is the bottom chakra, right? It's right around your hip level, just above your pelvic bone. And it governs all of your feelings of safety and security. Right? We've all kind of had that rocked in the last 2 months. So we need to keep that chakra open. Keep ourselves rooted and grounded. When we start to feel unsteady in the root chakra, we store all the negative emotions right in our hips, right? All those feelings of uncertainty, of fear, of frustration. That's what we're doing here. We're opening up the hips. All right, as you inhale next, you can pull those legs back up. So you're putting your left foot back on the floor, so your left foot should still be on the left edge of your mat as you come back up. And then you're just going to take your right foot down, right? Put your right foot even with your right glute, and then bring that left heel in so it's even with your left glute. So we're going to do both those poses on the other side now. So you're going to lift your left foot up, put your left ankle on top of your right knee, and just let your left knee fall open. So now we're here in this figure four on the other side. Now you're going to pick your right foot up. Start to draw that right leg in towards your body. Your right hand's going to go to the inside of your left hand's going to go to the inside of your right thigh. Right hand's going to go to the outside of your right thigh. Hands interlace around the right thigh, and you pull that right leg in a little more toward your body. Again, you can kick the right foot up straight up to the sky if that feels good. You can drop the right heel all the way down to your right glute and wrap your hands around your shin, or you can stay where you are with a little semi-bend in your right knee. The more you pull that right leg in toward your body, the more you're going to feel the left hip. For most of us, we've got a little bit more going on in the left hip, so we feel it a little more, a little sooner. Just because we're right side dominant, that means our dominant side gets a little looser and our non-dominant side, for most people at the left, gets a little tighter. If you got more space on this side, then you should take that extra space. If you're like most people and it's tighter on the left side, don't feel like you have to force yourself anywhere just because of what you did on the right side. And again, that edge, got that sensation going on, but it's not too much. You can still hang out for the next minute. going to release behind that right leg. Right foot is going to come all the way down. And again, you want to move that right foot. Sit into the right edge of your mat. Of course, it's still in the center of your mat. You just move that right foot over. And then we're going to take that twist here. So you're using your left foot to draw your right knee over to the left side of your body. So both these fall to the left. Right? You guys can see a little better on this side what I do with the block, right? Because I can't quite get that left knee down here, so I'm taking the block. You can bring it underneath your knee if your knee's up this high, right? Or maybe you take it underneath your thigh or your hip. That feels better, right? Just find your spot where it feels good to you. We're coming back to those cactus arms like we did before. And you're letting your gaze go over your right shoulder. That's where you want to be here, in the twist. On your next inhale, pull those knees back up so your right foot comes to the floor at the edge of your mat. Then you're going to take that left foot down. It's a both feet are back on the mat. Again, you're going to bring those feet to about hip-width distance apart. All right, now from here, you're going to keep your right foot planted on the ground where it is, right? So it's aligned now with your right hip. And just let that left knee fall all the way open towards the ground. So I've got the sole of my left foot is pointed towards the right side of the room. My left knee is falling open. Now again, you can use the block here if you need to, or your blanket support underneath your left knee if it doesn't come all the way to the ground. Keep that right knee pointed up to the sky just for the minute here, right? So we're a little half reclining bound ankle. Just like a regular reclining bound ankle, you can do what you want with your hands. They can rest on your belly. They can rest at your sides. You take your left hand and push a little bit further down on that left inner thigh, left knee, if you like that. Or you can take your arms and reach them towards the back of the room, open up the upper body a little bit. You can always be in those cactus arms. Okay? All good options. We're eventually going to come to the full version, but we're taking these little half versions first. Take three more breaths right here. Heel line up with your left glute, and then you're going to let your right knee fall open to the right. And again, from here, you can take the block, you can support underneath that right knee if you need it. You just let that right knee fall open. Your right, sole of your right foot should be up off the mat, pointed towards the left side of the room. You can do the same thing with your hands you did on the other side. You can do something different. Okay. And we're trying to open up that right inner thigh, so if you want to, you can use your right hand to press that right leg down further. You want your left knee to stay pointed straight up to the sky, right? It's kind of grounding, allowing that right leg to open a little more. In a second here, we'll do the full version of the pose. And you'll see the difference, feel the difference, I should say. You're going to pull that right leg back up. Now walk your feet all the way close together so that your big toes, the ball of your big toes are touching, right? And then you're going to take both legs and let them fall open to the sides so that the soles of your feet come together. Right? You feel that sensation. Now maybe you need to support here. The block underneath one leg or both legs. You can always, if you need to back it off a little bit, push your heels further away from your body if you're feeling too much sensation and you don't have the block. Right? If you want to, you can pull those heels closer in and make it a deeper sensation. Whatever you need here. Again, it's whatever you want to do with your hands. They can be on your belly, at your sides, pushing down on your legs, going overhead. Make it comfortable to you. Stay the full 2 minutes here. On the ground. Alright? And now take your knees, hug them into your chest. You can kind of give it a rock back and forth here. Make some more lumbar circles if you want. We're going to finish off our movement with just one final twist. Right? So let your arms fall out like wings in the T position. If you want to do those cactus arms again, that's an option. Let both knees fall to the right. So this time you just stack your left knee on top of your right. You're taking your gaze over your left shoulder. Now if you want to here, you're going to take your right hand, bring it closer to the earth. Bring your knees closer to the earth, that's what I'm going to say. So pressing down on those knees. Or maybe if you have enough space and it feels good, maybe you extend your legs so your toes reach towards your right elbow, right fingertips. That's too much. Bend. Up to you. Four breaths here. Next inhale, pull those knees back up to center one last time, give them one final hug into your chest. let's set up for our final pose, our Shavasana. Right? Let your legs go out long. Take your hands to your sides, palms face down. Stay right there if you want to, or you can take any variation of Shavasana you want. Maybe you want to take that Tootsie Roll back under your knees like we did at the beginning. Right? Maybe you want to butterfly your legs. Come up a little bit more. Maybe you need to roll to your side, or onto your belly. Just find a place where you're perfectly comfortable. Slowly start to come back into the room. Feel your fingers, your toes, feeling that anchor sensation. Close here. Just our two more breaths and then an om. Alright? More breath, we inhale. As we exhale, make that little humming sound back of the throat. The om is the universal syllable. Please still press the throat. You can join me in the breaths. So you can just listen. But let's close our eyes here. We'll inhale together. Open. hands to heart center. Thank you, all of you, for sharing your energy, your practice with me this evening. The light in me honors the light in each of you. Namaste.
Namaste.
Last night, your lives will feel better later on tonight, I promise, if they don't already. I will see you guys all on Saturday for some slow flow. Oh, I'm not down. Can't even see what I'm doing anymore. Seema's going to be here tomorrow morning for some Bollywood in the morning, so come join her. All right, see you guys all later. Bye.